Central Park Summer Stage. Featuring Ben Folds.
Hey, baby. Good night.
If you're going to play piano by yourself for an hour, 2 hours, or whatever, there's not that much variety, really, that meets the eye. When you first get in, it was dude singing at piano, and that's a long time, so I have to find dynamics to the set that make it feel like, you know, a short movie, you know. And there is some thought that goes into that. Once I've established my cadences, where I'm going to go up and where I'm going to go down, and I have a skeleton of three or four songs that anchor the dynamics of the set. Then the rest of it's whatever I feel like playing at the moment. And you know, I've had kids come up and say, "You've been playing the same set every night for 3 weeks," and that's never true. I walk on stage knowing I'm going to play four songs, and the rest of it is just, you know, I mean, I've written, you know, hundreds of songs, so I pick from something and do it. And I think that it's those, I have a song called Zak and Sara, which I always put second. It's just my comfort zone. When I don't put that second, I can't play.
Sarah spelled without the H was getting bored on a PV amp in 1984. While Zach without a C tried out some new guitars, playing Sarah with no H's favorite song. La la da 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 la da da. La da 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 la da da. Zach and Sarah. Spells where she lost time. She saw the future, she heard voices from inside. The kind of voices she would soon learn to deny. Because at home they got her smack. La da 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 la da 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 la da 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 la da da. Was that cancer?
Special audience. If no other reason, it's just New York. There's just something about it. And you're like, ooh, you're playing New York. It used to intimidate me a little bit way back in the day just because I thought that everyone in New York knew something that I didn't know. And now I realize that almost everybody knows something that I don't know, so it doesn't bother me. But I'm always grateful when I play here. I played my very first solo gig at the piano by myself, scared to death in New York at the Bowery Ballroom. And that was a, you know, kind of a turning point for me.
Damn good to be here. Here's a song. Son, look at all the people in this restaurant. What do you think they weigh? Look out the window into the parking lot at their SUVs. taking all of the space. They give no fuck, they talk as loud as they want. They give no fuck, just as long as there's enough for them. Gonna get on the microphone down at Walmart, talk about some shit that's been on my mind. Talk about the state of this great nation of ours. People look to your left, yeah, look to your right. They give no fuck, they buy as much as they want. They give no fuck, just as long as there's enough for them. See them in the National Geographic, squatting bare-assed in the dirt, eating rice from a bowl, with a towel on their heads or maybe a bone in their nose. See that asshole with the peace sign on his license plate, giving me the finger and running me out of his lane. God made us number one, 'cause he loves us the best. Well, maybe he should go bless someone else for a while and give us a rest. Yes, and everyone can see. We've eaten all that we can eat. Me and my friend Ryan of Guster, close personal friend of mine now, we were just talking backstage about how, you know, we've been doing this tour now for about 3 weeks, and we take turns playing last, and we were talking about how tough it is to have to follow Rufus Wainwright, and he was agreeing. Ryan said, yeah, Ben, you know, he goes out there, he's dressed well, he's singing his ass off. He's like, he's got those opera chops, and then you go out right after him to go, shit, fuck, shit, fuck. So that's what I'm gonna do. The rest of the night. Thank you very much. Shit, goddamn. I want to apologize to the TV station I played on today for saying shit 3 times in the morning like that.
Radio involvement or not has had very, very little to do with what I played live and what people liked live in general, which has been a nice thing. My band had one hit. I guess that makes us a one-hit wonder, although I feel like we had enough almost hits to where maybe that we don't count as that. Because if a one-hit wonder would be someone who came and just disappeared, right? That's what we did.
Here's a song. Here's a song for my 4-year-old daughter, Gracie. It's called Gracie. No shits or fucks in this one.
You can't fool me, I saw you when you came out. You got
got your mama's taste, but you got my mouth. And you will always have a part of me. Nobody else is ever gonna see you, Gracie girl. With your cards to your chest, walking on your toes. What you got in the box, only Gracie knows. But I would never try to make you be anything you didn't really want to be, Gracie girl. Life flies by in seconds. You're not a baby, Gracie, you're my friend. You'll be a lady soon, but until then, you've got to do what I say. You nodded off in my arms watching TV. I won't move you an inch even though my arm's asleep. Gracie girl.
Thank you. I'd like to bring up Rufus Wainwright, if he's still around.
Rufus Wainwright comes up and we do a George Michael song. No, it's a Wham song, Careless Whisper. And that's probably the highlight of the set for me. I wait, that's like my little bump in the middle of the set where I wait for Rufus to come out and we get to play 80s music.
Gee, shucks. Shit.
Thanks, man, it makes me feel better.
You're a much better piano player than I am. Putting that on the record.
And you're prettier than I am, so.
So unsure as I take your hand and lead you to the dance floor. As the music dies, something in your eyes calls to mind the silver screen and all its sad goodbye.
I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet ain't got no. With you. crowd.
Baby, it's better this way. We hurt each other with the things we born to say.
We could have been so good together.
We could have made this last forever, but now.
Said, yeah, we should do something together. That was just a natural thing, but he owns it. Like, he's the real deal singing that song. He sings it so well that I have to sing it well then. So he's like, I'm never gonna dance again. I'm like, yeah, me neither.
When she crept back in the house at 3:30, shook her head to see him snoring in his sleep. If he really loved me, she said, I wouldn't have to be so mean.
Central Park was supposed to be in the middle of the city. I don't know, it's famous, you know. As far as music goes, you think of Barbara Streisand in Central Park, and the story about it was raining all day long, and then it cleared up before she played. Hey. Could happen.
Man, it's so cool that it's clearing up. That's a good thing. I'll be worried if the sun comes out right now, but that, you know. Rock this bitch. I've played this song 1,000 times with lots of different chords, sometimes different words, 'cause some motherfucker in Chicago yelled it out one night. He said, rock this bitch. He said, rock this bitch. He said, rock this bitch. And I say that I'm tired of that song, so I'm gonna make an up a new one here in New York City tonight. R-O-C-K with your C-O-C-K out in NYC. R-O-C-K with your C-O-C-K out in NYC. Everybody sing R-O-C-K with your C-O-C-K out in NYC.
This is one of the better ways to play outside. There's something really dignified about it, as opposed to playing like, you know, one of those kind of sheds where everyone's up getting corn.